Ever wondered what it would be like to travel at the speed of light? Would time slow down or speed up? Would we see strange optical effects as we accelerate? And most importantly, could we even reach the speed of light in the first place? In the next 16 minutes, we'll be exploring the mind-boggling physics of light and the fundamental properties of the universe as we ride the cosmic waves and dive into the wonders of light-speed travel. We will dive into the practical implications of light-speed travel, from the potential to explore distant galaxies to the possibility of time travel itself. Let's begin. Imagine we are going on a thrilling journey through the cosmos aboard a spaceship, accelerating away from Earth and moving faster and faster. As we journey through the infinite expanse of the universe, our imaginations run wild with the tantalizing possibilities of what we would behold if we were to relentlessly accelerate through the cosmos. What optical effects would occur? And if we could try to exceed light speed by bending space-time, like in our favorite sci-fi movies, Interstellar and Star Trek, what kind of phenomena would we witness? Answering these questions would lead us on an incredible journey of discovery, exploring the fundamental properties of our universe and immersing ourselves in the mysteries of special and general relativity. As our spacecraft takes off, we feel the G-forces pressing into our seats as we accelerate into the great unknown. With each passing moment, we move farther and farther away from Earth, propelled by the power of our ship's engines. But wait, something strange happens. Even as we approach the speed of light, we don't feel the acceleration like we expected. It's like being on a high-speed train, hurtling towards the horizon without a care in the world. As we look out the window, we see Earth receding further and further into the distance, and we can't help but feel a sense of awe at the sheer vastness of the universe. But as we approach dangerous speeds, there's a real risk of collision with space debris. Even the tiniest particle could wreak havoc on our ship. Luckily, we've come prepared. Our vessel is equipped with a force field that repels all manner of space junk, from asteroids to micrometeoroids, thus allowing us to roam freely through space. As we move faster and faster, we'll witness fascinating optical effects and dive into the mysteries of special and general relativity. At first, we experience an optical effect called aberration of light, where the stars in front of us seem to move away gradually. This is similar to driving in a car during a rainstorm. The raindrops appear to fall from the front instead of vertically, due to the car's motion. Also, the laws of physics come into play in fascinating ways. One of the most intriguing phenomena is the way light behaves as we approach the speed of light. According to Einstein's theory of relativity, the speed of light is always constant, regardless of the motion of the observer. However, as we accelerate towards the speed of light, strange things start to happen. Light rays that were once behind us suddenly appear to come from the front, as if we're chasing after them. This is because the light rays that were originally emitted from a source behind us are now being caught up by our ship as we move forward, creating the illusion that they're coming from the front. Additionally, the direction of the stars appears to change as we accelerate through space. This is due to the way that our perspective shifts as we move closer to the speed of light. Just as a person's view of the world changes as they move faster, so too does our view of the stars change as we approach the speed of light. As we continue to accelerate through the vast expanse of space, we witness a stunning contrast between the intense light in front of us and the darkness that seems to widen and deepen behind us. This phenomenon also results in the distortion of images and objects around us, causing straight lines to bend and objects to appear angled in our direction. This is known as the Penrose rotation, which can be quite disorienting. Despite the exhilarating experience, we must be cautious of the dangers associated with high speeds. Even a speck of dust could cause significant damage if we collide with it. Fortunately, our spaceship is equipped with a force field that repels dangerous objects, allowing us to roam freely through space. This technology also allows us to avoid potential collisions with objects that may be affected by the Doppler effect, making our space travel safer and more efficient. Ever wondered how astronomers can tell us what stars looked like thousands of years ago? Well, the answer lies in the Doppler effect. When we look at a distant star, the light we see has traveled billions of kilometers through space and taken some time to reach us. As a result, we are seeing the star as it appeared in the past, perhaps thousands of years ago. The same phenomenon happens when we're in a spaceship and moving away from Earth. The planet's light takes longer and longer to reach us, and if we were to zoom in with a telescope, we'd see people on Earth evolving in slow motion. This is the Doppler effect in action. As the ship moves faster and faster, we'd see a shift in the color of the stars. In front of us, the stars would shift towards blue and seem to take faster, while the image of the planet behind us would shift towards red and appear to weaken. All of these effects are only optical illusions due to the way we receive light while moving. But if we were to approach light speed, real physical effects would kick in with irreversible consequences. This is where special relativity comes into play. And one of the first consequences of relativity is time dilation. Our universe is a fascinating and vast four-dimensional fabric called space-time. It's made up of three dimensions of space and one dimension of time. Inside this fabric, all bodies trace a trajectory as they advance towards their future. But did you know that the trajectory of an object can be affected by its speed and direction? For example, let's say that we launch a spaceship from Earth, and it begins moving in the same direction as the planet towards the future. However, as the spaceship picks up speed and zooms away from Earth faster and faster, its trajectory gradually deviates from that of the planet. This means that the axis we call time is no longer aligned with the time axis of people on Earth. If the spaceship were to turn around and come back to Earth, the clocks on board would have measured a different time, and the crew would have aged less than Earthlings because their trajectories in space-time would have been different. This is one of the key consequences of special relativity, known as time dilation. But that's not all. Another fascinating consequence of special relativity is length contraction, which states that as an object moves faster through space-time, its length contracts in the direction of motion. This means that an object appears shorter when it's moving at high speeds than when it's at rest. Length contraction is a fascinating consequence of special relativity. It refers to the phenomenon where the light of an object appears to shorten in the direction of its motion as it approaches light speed. From the perspective of a spaceship traveling at near light speed, the entire universe seems to be moving backward. As a result, the universe appears to be contracted along the spaceship's direction of motion. This means that the journey to reach a destination would seem shorter than expected. In fact, it would take less and less time the faster the spaceship moves. Contrary to popular misconception, it is indeed possible to travel thousands of light years in just a few seconds. If the spaceship were to move at almost light speed, the journey would even seem instantaneous. However, for people on Earth, several thousand years would have passed. Length contraction is a real phenomenon, but it is visually challenging to observe. Crossing the orbit of a planet, for example, would not be enough to see its length contract visibly. This is because the farther we look into space, the farther we look into the past. Therefore, the back of the planet, which is located further in space, appears to us as it was in the past. Even if it appears contracted, we do not see it that way because we receive the image of its back with a delay. Instead, it seems to be rotated. This phenomenon is known as Terrell-Penrose rotation. When we move very fast and look to our side, the edges of objects around us appear shorter in the direction of motion. This can be interpreted either as length contraction, or as a rotation, or change in perspective. Therefore, a person watching a spaceship zoom by would not see it contracted, but rather rotated on itself. As we venture into the depths of space, our field of view continues to shrink. The speed of light, once thought to be infinite, is now a limiting factor. It's a constant reminder that no matter how fast we accelerate, we'll never be able to catch up to light. But what would happen if we could reach the speed of light? This answer has long been a topic of discussion in the world of relativity. And the answer is simple. We can't. Even if we constantly accelerated, we'd never reach the speed of light because it's an absolute. The faster we go, the more our field of vision shrinks until it forms an infinitely bright spot in front of us, surrounded by a completely black sky. At almost light speed, all optical effects would become extreme. As we catch up with the light rays before us, they all seem to come from the front. Meanwhile, the rays behind us can never reach us. For a person on Earth, we'd be moving at the speed of light. But for us, the trip seems instantaneous as we move infinitely fast. Simply put, nothing can ever move faster than light through space. However, there might be a way to circumvent this rule, such as using a warp drive. The basic idea of a warp drive is to create a bubble of space-time around a spaceship and propel that bubble faster than the speed of light, essentially surfing on a wave of faster-than-light space-time. This would eliminate the need to travel through space at high speeds, making interstellar travel much more feasible. However, producing a warp drive would require bending space-time with huge amounts of negative mass, a form of matter that has never been observed in our universe. As a result, achieving this kind of technology is currently thought to be impossible. If we could observe a warp drive from outside, it would appear out of nowhere due to the curvature of space-time. The trajectory of light rays would be deviated, forming a moving lens that splits into two parts, one moving forward and the other retreating in the opposite direction. Because light travels slower than the warp drive itself, when it approaches, the light has not yet had time to reach us. After it crosses us, we receive both the light that had not yet reached us and the rays that were emitted later. Looking from the inside of the warp drive would be an entirely different experience. The sky in front of us would appear contracted and very bright, while the universe behind us would look extremely dark. A whole patch of the sky would simply vanish from our view, because the light emitted from there is too slow to catch up with us. This creates a cone of the universe that remains permanently invisible to us. The experience of traveling through a warp drive could be truly mind-bending, and unlike anything we have ever experienced before. In short, the concept of light-speed travel is an exciting and intriguing possibility that has captured the imagination of scientists and science fiction enthusiasts alike. While current scientific understanding suggests that traveling faster than the speed of light is impossible, the idea of using the fabric of space-time itself to propel a spacecraft at faster-than-light speeds through the use of a warp drive remains a fascinating possibility. But there's no denying that the discovery of a practical method for light-speed travel could have a significant impact on humanity's exploration of the universe and our understanding of it. If such a method were possible, it could potentially open up new possibilities for space travel and colonization, as it would greatly reduce the amount of time required to travel vast distances. For instance, it could make it possible for humans to explore and study distant planets and stars in a more efficient manner. However, the discovery of a practical method for light-speed travel would also bring unforeseen consequences and challenges. One of the most significant challenges would be related to the immense amount of energy required to achieve light-speed travel, as well as the potential risks associated with such high speeds. Additionally, the potential impact on human biology and health from traveling at such speeds would need to be carefully considered. What do you think scientists and engineers can do to make light-speed travel a reality? Like, share, comment, and watch more content like this here.